And now we're gone. We might not yet be flung to the four corners, but that will happen in due course. None of us could have predicted finishing our journey in this way during these extraordinarily challenging times, but here we are. I still remember promising to see you graduate all of those years ago, and so I hope that this message is one that both honours my commitment to you and also provides as close a thing as we can get to having a formal farewell with the school closed. Where do I start? We have seen so much, we have travelled so far, and we have said goodbye to so many people along the way. We've endured earthquakes and border blockades, we've rejoiced at each other's successes, we've cried at each other's pains, and we've provided shoulders to cry on for the individual challenges we've all faced over the years. And of course, we have grown. I'm thankful that growth is mandatory. It is inescapable, non-negotiable, inevitable, and it is thoroughly rewarding. When I look back and I see how all of you have grown over these last 6 years in physical stature, in mental agility, in emotional stability, and in spiritual honesty, I will say, at the risk of repeating myself, what a massive privilege it has been to be your homeroom teacher. My own physical stature and mental agility is now doubtless in decline, but when I see what all of you have to offer, I'm genuinely excited for the next chapter of your lives. And I'm also genuinely excited for the places around the world where you will move to, with so many opportunities to impact others for the better. We don't have time here to retell all the stories of our journey. There are too many for that. But as the years continue, I pray that these stories may jog deeper memories of laughter, of challenge, of friendship, and of love. And so now, I think the best thing for me to do is to take the role one last time. Good morning, Daniel. Thank you for your constant inquisitiveness in class and your sporting passion. You are a model of determination and you deserve the very best that Pakistan can give. I am just so sorry that I couldn't engage with you like Mr. Bleakley could when it came to discussing current affairs in world cricket. Good morning, Someng. Thank you for your quiet determination as well, and your wonderful empathy and deep concern for others. The way you uplifted the entire school community every time you sang is something I will not forget, and I'm so grateful for your willingness to have served us in this way. Good morning, David. Thank you for your willingness and enthusiasm to get involved in absolutely everything, practical, musical, sportical, and for the way that you demonstrate initiative and calm, servant-hearted leadership. You remain a model of stoic unflappability, and that is a proper word. Good morning, B. Thank you for sticking it out to the end. You hid your talents for too long, but I'm thankful that you gave us so much this year. Your million-dollar win on Survivor, as Mum escaping the kids for a bit, remains, I'm pretty sure, the loudest laugh that we've got for anything that we've ever done in homeroom. Good morning, Joy. You remain to the end, true to your name. I'm sure that you have had a bad day, but I've just never seen you have one. Your smile, your kindness, and your care shows Jesus to everybody that you meet. Your constant optimism is wonderfully infectious. And I am eternally grateful for all the birthday cakes that you cooked for me over the years. Good morning, Ashish. How you have modelled excellence in so many ways is a real credit to you. Your attention to detail, your natural giftings, and your willingness to serve the school at the very highest level speak volumes about you. And the violin masterclasses that you gave the whole school were very special. Good morning, Arnika. Thank you for your diligence, your thoughtfulness, and your care for others. Your creativity and imagination have always been both abundant and refreshing. You have assumed so many different roles over the years, always done with good-humoured excellence. But for me, you will always be the Tanzan weather girl. Good morning, Yewon. Your quiet smile and easygoing manner belies a caring heart of outrageous depth. I know that your kindness has moved people to tears, and I just thank you for who you are, as simple as that. I am also so grateful to you for sharing your gifts by playing the piano with such style in all the school assemblies for us. Good morning, Nate. What a ride you have taken us on this year. I think you saved your best until last. From headlining the musical to writing and directing all of us in the best video that we've ever made as a homeroom, I think you have truly grabbed our final year and shaken the life out of it. Thank you for all the creative energy that you have poured into our class. Good morning, Jiyun. Thank you for being such a great model of reliability and diligence. I value your practical service to the class, your tireless work with the organising and accounting of our fundraising efforts. I'm just so sorry that we couldn't spend what you looked after. But thank you even more for your calming and caring spirit that just lifts other people up. Good morning, Selena. I think I can say that you took the advice and you've had no regrets this year. You've got stuck into everything with 100% effort. Whether it's on the football pitch, on the basketball court, or on the school stage, your passion for life and your raw talent has shone through. Thank you for blessing us with your beautiful voice and your constant smile. Good morning, JJ. The thoroughness and diligence in the way that you approach everything in life is an example to us all. Both the literal and the metaphorical spring in your step is powerful and refreshing. Your commitment to our homeroom cause has been relentless, and you tire me out just watching you. Singapore is about to become an even richer place. Good morning, Aryan. Thank you for making me work so hard in class to stay one step ahead of your questions, although I often didn't manage to. Your amazing intellect, your piercing insight, and massive knowledge of the world is matched only by your razor-sharp wit, universal kindness, and genuine humility. You are a true servant-hearted leader. And last but not least, good morning, Anuja. You remain an example to us all in your passion for social justice and wanting to see the right things happen in this world. It has been a privilege to know you and your family while being here in Nepal. Thank you for engaging with all of our crazy homeroom ideas and dishing out more than your fair share of the clever banter. And it is fitting to remember as well those from the class of 2020 that have gone before us. Miriam, Roswin, Chani, Lucy, Gabriel, Zachary, and Kevin. We do not forget the huge contributions they have made over the years to our class and the enrichment of our lives in so many ways because of them. U2's vocalist, Bono, once sang as a young man that I can't change the world, but I can change the world in me. I think history has since suggested he was being a little bit modest in his outlook. Yes, while all of us can change our own internal attitudes and the way we react to circumstances, hopefully with ever more grace, patience, and understanding, I believe that you have the potential now to go on from here and to actually change the world beyond yourself and the immediate surroundings. Whether in the wider community, in the church, who knows, even in economics or, heaven help us, politics, you will have something of value to offer. You are all very able. The question is, are you willing? And if you think I am being melodramatic or exaggerating just for this moment, all I have to do is to look at the contributions your parents have made to Nepal to know that you are capable of equally great and even greater things. I don't claim to have any answers for how to do this, but if you'll allow me just to offer you three snippets of final advice as we part company. Firstly, and you've heard this one before, choose your friends very carefully. Secondly, don't think that just acquiring more money will make you happy. It won't. Thirdly, if I may borrow from Yewon's personal mission statement written all the way back in grade 9, it's Proverbs chapter 3, verses 5 and 6. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge him, and he will make your path straight. Thank you for making my work and my calling over these last 6 years so much fun. As we know right now, life can be very unfair. But I'm one of those fortunate people who truly love my job, and I thank you for it. All of you both exemplify and personify all of the reasons why I became a teacher many years ago. For some of us now then, this is goodbye. For some, I'm sure we'll meet again in happier circumstances. Until then, I'll leave you with a four-line poem that my mum sent to me last year. Only for these I pray, pray with assurance strong, light to discover the way, courage to follow it along. And so, class of 2020, unique in every way, I say one last thank you, farewell, and may God bless you richly for the future. You are all wonderful.